This tutorial will walk you through a simple loop of columns in a row. Here is a sneak peek of the output, which we will generate from this basic loop macro in Excel using Visual Basic for Applications. Most Excel users know we can drag across a couple of cells like this in order to generate a pattern of cell values. For example, from 1 to 10, like this. Go to Visual Basic for Applications and insert a module. The main goal from this video is to show Excel users how to compose a simple looping macro based on a simple parameter. More specifically, we will write a looping macro to loop through columns in a row in a spreadsheet. In general, it is wise to add the option explicit syntax at the top of the module. The option explicit will force us to declare all of the variables in a specific macro, such as this one. It will help to lessen the risk of runtime errors whilst the macro is running. Let's call the macro loop columns row. Remember to disable these Excel properties, which pertain to the calculation, event, and screen properties. Then we need to declare our object variables. The I object will be declared as a long variable. Whilst both RNG and start cell will be declared as range object variables, as we need these objects to denote cells or multiple cells in VBA. The start cell range object will be declared as the starting or active cell for this exercise, whilst RNG will be the selected range of cells. We are now ready to add the key learning component of this video, the basic looping code to cycle across columns in a row based on a simple criteria. The for next loop is one approach to loop through a range of cells. In this example, the loop will run based on the I object variables of I of. In this example, the loop will run based on the I object variables of 1 to 10. Given we want the first cell or start cell to be the first cell to input a value, we want the offset syntax to be 00 for the first loop of I, when I is 1. Given we don't want to move the macro down or up any rows nor columns for the first loop. Hence, the first loop of I, 1, will generate the output value of 1. The I variable can now move to 2 in order for this loop to run again. The cursor will move one column across and the input value will be 2. Our loop will continue to loop until the I variable reaches 10. It will then exit the loop and place the cursor back at the initial cell or start cell object variable. The macro is finished running. We can now re-enable those three Excel properties that were previously disabled. Our macro is now complete. Let's review our macro before we run the macro in our spreadsheet. Let's run the macro. As we can see, the macro is successfully looping across the columns in a row of cells and generating the respective number of outputs. Feel free to like this post, send us a comment, or subscribe to our channel.